नमस्कार स्टूडेंट्स, इन्फॉर्मेटिक्स प्रैक्टिसेस क्लास 12 यूनिट 1 डेटा हैंडलिंग यूजिंग पांडास एंड डेटा विजुअलाइजेशन। सो इन दिस वीडियो आई विल एक्सप्लेन इंपोर्टिंग डेटा फ्रॉम डेटा फ्रेम टू सीएसवी फाइल। सो माइसेल्फ संजय परमार, आई वेलकम यू ऑल ऑन माय चैनल ट्यूटोरियल एआईसीएस आईपी। सो लेट वी बिगिन दिस वीडियो। इन दिस वीडियो यू विल लर्न अबाउट व्हाट आर सीएसवी फाइल्स, एडवांटेजेस ऑफ सीएसवी फाइल्स, फाइल ऑपरेशंस and two underscore CSV functions. So let me begin. Watch the complete video to understand how the concept is working and how you can import your data frame data to CSV file. So first, what are CSV files? So when we talk about CSV, the full form of CSV is comma separated values. That means the files values which are separated by comma. So let me give one example. Suppose one, then name is there, then some data. So here three values are provided and these all three values separated by comma. So here comma is there, here comma is there. So this type of format can be saved in CSV file, and these CSV files can be operated or can be read through Notepad and Excel. In Excel also you can open this file, and in Notepad also you can open this file and read the data. So these are the CSV files. So when you want to save it, you have to save with .csv extension. Here, whenever you are creating CSV file with Notepad, the extension should be provided. Otherwise, it will saved as .txt file. So basic files, as you know, PDF file, DOC file. So this is also one kind of format. So now when you are working with file handling in Python, so Python can operate three types of files basically. First, text file they can operate, that is not part of IP syllabus. Then binary files, that is also not a part of IP syllabus, it is part of computer science syllabus. If you want to watch those videos, I will upload those videos also, so you can watch how to handle data between text file to binary files. Now text files means what? Those files which have the extension of .txt, simply text is inserted in your file. Binary file means those files have data which cannot be read by user directly. In text file you can read data directly, like I have written here 1 Sanjay 2500. So this you can read, but in binary file you cannot read. It can be read by the computer itself. Okay, so that is called binary. So those files are there, like images, then songs, audio, MP3, MP4 files. So those all are considered as binary files. Basically, these files are very large in size and it can be read by computers only. Then CSV, third CSV. So they have given this is separate data handling function as CSV, so that comma separated values can be accepted rather than using database. Because when you are using database, you need to learn so many functions of database, then you can operate that one. So that we will discuss in advantages of CSV file. So let me start the next point, advantages of CSV file. The first advantage, as I said, no need to install any other software. CSV file you can read from Python to CSV, means when it is written in your CSV file, all data is written in your CSV file, you can open those files directly by Notepad or Excel. If MS Excel is there, you can use MS Excel. Otherwise, some OpenOffice tools are also there, freeware software like OpenOffice Calci, then LibreOffice Calci. So those you can use for reading this CSV file. So there is no need to install any other software. If you have Office package, that you can use. If Office package is also not there, you can read and write this data through Notepad also. So that can be accepted. So that is global form and main advantage of CSV file. Another is, it is common accepted format. CSV is very common accepted format. Somewhere you want to work and the person who is working on that computer, so when database is there, that database is required, that software is required to operate that particular database in that particular computer also. So that is also big advantage. If you are working with CSV file, the user to whom you are providing your application, they need not to install any other software. After that, third advantage is there, as a developer, you should not learn anything related to database when you are transferring data from data frame to CSV file, because here only one function is there to transfer your data to _CSV. Okay, so that you can use simply like that only, and that you have to learn this function only. No need to provide any connectivity or anything. Although there are many advantages of database tools also, but when we are transferring on only simple data and we are operating a simple kind of database, you can use CSV file. Even CSV file can handle large data also. So that can be also operated. So comma separated value, you can put all the values in comma separated form and you can operate. The next topic is file operations. So what are the operations associated with your file? So first operation is creating file. First is create only. When with files, you need to create your file, whether it is blank file or with data, so that you can create. After that, whenever you are creating your file, it should be open first. When you open it, then you can perform any other operations. So first operation is create, next is open, and with open you have to specify the mode. Mode is basically what you want to perform, which kind of task you want to perform in that particular file. That is known as mode. Then read, write, append, and close. Read means if file is already created, now you want to read that file through Python, then you can use read. Write, you want to write something from Python program to that particular file. So there write operation. If file is created, now you want to add some data, you want to add records, then you can use append methods. And last one is close. Whenever you are completing your work, at last you have to close your file. So that close function is there. So for these all operations, Python is providing functions. So those functions we have to use. Now let me start and understand _CSV function. So whenever you want to transfer data from data frame to CSV file, you have to use CSV function. So in this video, you just learn about how to write _CSV file. Other parameters I will discuss in next video. Otherwise, this video will be very longer. So that's why just I will store data from data frame to CSV file. So let understand the steps. So the first step is, in this video I will explain this thing. Employee data I am saving in CSV file through data frame. So I have created one dictionary first. That dictionary name is emp_dict. Then data frame created using pandas. So that I have already uploaded videos how to create data frame that you can watch. Data exported into my data.csv file using _CSV file. So simply we are writing df.2csv, and then we can write the file name. Then CSV file open through open function with read mode. So whenever after that you want to read something from that file, you can use this function. So I have used the similar functions, f=mydata.csvr, then data=f.read, then data printed, and f.close. So let me do this in program. Here I have already created that data frame dictionary. Then that dictionary is added to your data frame, and then this function. So let me run this program, f5. See, now let me check the file is created or not. Here I have written the path dmydata.csv. Sagar, Mohit, Arjun, Manav, Malay, Ketu, 2024, 2026, 2025. This data is imported or not? Let me check. So first I will open computer from here, and then D drives. Then here you can see my data. Okay, so this is my data.csv file. So by default it is opening in Excel. See, name, age, salary. These are the index, and these are the first column, name, age, salary, and all data is already inserted. So I hope you understood how to export your data frame data to CSV file. So this way you can use this CSV file. Now let me read through this program. Now in program, first we have to open our file. So for that, I have created one file object, f=open, then write the file. So file path we have already given here. That only I will copy. copy. And this I want to read data, so that mode you have to specify. Okay, now file is already loaded into the buffer of Python. Now next is data. So this common variable you have to take to store your data, whatever data received from that particular CSV file. So that we have written data equal to f dot. Now here what you will do, simply read function you have to use. Here I have written that one, read function you have to use. So that right here f dot read, then print data. So that will print the final data, print data. You can use custom format to print your data in results. When you complete this work, write f dot close. So that I will demonstrate straight in another video how to format your data, whatever data we have received from CSV file. Okay, so here it is printing this data. So like this you can use different kind of functions and import data from data to CSV file. So that's all from this video. Thank you for watching this video. And if you are coming to my channel first time, watching my video first time, subscribe the channel and press bell notification icon. And if you like my videos, hit the like button, comment your doubts and comment your feelings as well for these videos. Thank you for watching again. Keep watching, keep learning.